Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, I am N. Mallesh, working as a assistant professor in English in Saint Martin's Engineering College. Today, I would like to start one topic on lesson unit 5, that is how a Chinese billionaire built her fortune. The title is how a Chinese billionaire built her fortune. Here we have to see the parts of speech. See, mostly all are in the capital letters only. All the words started with the capital letters only, except the article A. How is a pronoun, interrogative pronoun. And also sometimes it works as adverb too. Okay, how is the parts of speech is a pronoun. A is a article. Article countable, it is used before countable nouns. You see Chinese. Chinese is a singular one. Singular. Before Chinese billionaire, before singular noun, we will use the A article. And will be used in before vowel sound, like an apple. Here, Chinese. I am saying about the parts of speech of individual words. It starts with the capital Chinese. Chinese, China is noun, proper noun. But here, Chinese means here, adjective, Chinese billionaire. Here, billionaire is a noun. Now, the place of adjective is before noun. This is adjective. So adjectives will explain about the noun. So here the word Chinese is explaining about billionaire. So this is adjective. Billionaire is a noun form. Noun form. Here see built. Built is a verb form. It started with the capital. Okay. Built is how it is a verb means here. It is indicating some action. Here see built. You know that some verb forms are there like build. Built and built, like a building. These are the verb forms. Okay, V1, V2, V3 and V4. That's why it is a verb. Next, last one is fortune, R. H-E-R-R is a pronoun. In pronouns, there are many types. This is a possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun means here, see, I, we, you, they, he, she, it are subjective pronouns. And here, me, us, you, them, objective pronouns. I'm saying about in lesson the parts of speech of this word. You see, he, him, and she, her, and here it, it. So here in the middle we will see some possessive pronouns like for I, my, for we, our, by you, your, and they, their, and he is here. Our point is here. This one, she means her. So here, her is there. This is possessive pronoun. Her fortunes means here, her life story, how it became. See here, how a Chinese billionaire built her fortune, how she built her future. See here, you can see she is Zhou Pinpei. She is Zhou Pinpei. In our cover page, we can see. Neatness of appearance we can see here, because in the first paragraph they discuss about our appearance. Okay, in this lesson vocabulary, grammar and writing are covered. In vocabulary, words often confused, and idioms and phrasal verbs, one word substitutes. In grammar, conditional sentences, degrees of comparison, simple complex compound, and sentences and common errors we will discuss. In writing task, essay writing topic will be discussed here. Objectives. Next year lesson, I'll read the lesson. Before that say explanation of lesson, I would like to say about this lesson. This is a good motivational lesson for any students, good motivational students for engineering students. Okay, she didn't become rich in a single day. She worked hard. She is the definition for success. She is the definition for hard work. She is the definition for persistence. All she followed, that's why she became successful rich man. Successful rich man, she didn't become in a single day. That's why the first two line itself, they mentioned that meet Zhou Pinpei, the world's richest self-made woman. Means that she was not the recipient of ancestors, their relatives' property. She only worked hard and also she became rich. So I'll read out the first paragraph. Meet Zhou Pinpei, the world's richest self-made woman. She is the founder of Lens Technology and counts a $27 million estate in Hong Kong among her acquisitions. but she is most at home on the floor of her factory, dipping her hands in a tray of water to ensure it is of the right temperature, or taking the place of one of her technicians for a while. If you met her, you would instantly notice her neatness of appearance, her round owl-like glasses and her cherubic face. The meaning of this paragraph means here, Jo Quinpe, she is the world's richest self-made woman. Means, she worked on herself, she became rich man, rich woman. He also discussed about, she is the founder of lens technology. In questions, they will ask like this, with the world's richest self-made woman, means, you see here, Jo Quinpe is the world's richest woman. And also, what is the name of the company she started? The name of the company is Lens Technology. She is the founder of Lens Technology. We will discuss completely about this lesson, about lenses only, whether it is mobile's lens or whether it is a watch's lens. This lesson is about lens only, LGNS lens. She is the founder of Lens Technology, and also she counts 27 million estate in Hong Kong. The place also here they mentioned in Hong Kong, 27 million dollars estate is there. She worked with other acquisitions means your partners. So here, but she is most at home on the floor of her factory, dipping her hands in a tray of water to ensure it is of the right temperature. Also, her place where she will stay means here, she will stay in the floor of the factory. Sometimes she comes out, and also she keep for measuring the temperature for making the glasses. Sometimes she comes and also she dips her fingers, and also she measures the temperature of the water. Then she can give sometimes relax or rest to the other employees too. And whenever you met her, you will see her face very attractive, and also how it will be appearance is good in cover page. You can see here. See next here. This is in grammar. If you see that, if you met her, this is a if class type 2. If you met her, if after subject and verb 2 is there. If you met her, you see, if you met her, you would instantly notice her neatness of appearance. See, then in a class, conditional class, this is a type 2 sentences. If you and met is the verb second form, and here would we will see. So this is type 2 if class. Okay, what is that means? If you met her, you would instantly notice her neatness of appearance. Whenever you see her neatness of appearance, like a cherubic face, attractive face, we will see. Next, the description of her round and oval-like glasses and her cherubic face means here, C-H-E-R-U-B-U-C, cherubic means here, attractive face. Next, in the second paragraph, the youngest of three children, Quinpe was born in a tiny village in China. She lost her mother when she was 5. Her father was a skilled craftsman. He lost his eyesight and a finger in an industrial accident. Young Quinpe helped her family raise pigs and ducks for their livelihood. So the meaning of this paragraph is that she is the third person in her family. The youngest means, eldest means youngest. Younger means, younger and youngest. Youngest is the last, last and small. Your youngest means last one in the family. So youngest children. So three members are there, she is the youngest. And where she born? She born in a tiny village in China. In questions also they will ask like this. Where was she born means here, she born in a tiny village in China. And also she lost her mother, L-O-S-T, lost. She lost her mother when she was 5. When when she was 5 years old, she lost her mother. And also her father was craftsman means here, who makes dolls and some in craft field he work, and when he was working in industry, he lost his finger and also he lost his eyesight. Due to that, In fact, what will happen, she had to work from childhood onwards. That's why she raised some animals for feeding their family. So second paragraph over, second paragraph complete about her background and childhood, where she born, and also about her mother. She lost her mother, and some discussion about father too. Father lost finger, and also here he lost eyesight. Due to that effect, what will happen, she used to raise some animals to feed their family. Next, despite being a brilliant student, Quinfei dropped out of school at the age of 16. She landed a job that required her to work from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. polishing glass. The hours were long and the work monotonous. After 3 months, she decided to quit. She wrote her letter of resignation to her boss, in which she complained of the long hours and the boredom. But she also said that she was grateful for the job and was willing to learn more. Her boss was impressed with the letter. He asked her to stay on and promoted her. The meaning of this paragraph means here, despite being a brilliant student, though she is a brilliant student, it is a complex sentence. A complex sentence will be formed you with a subordinate class, you know, here, in spite of her. So, though she is brilliant, she was dropped out. There are dropout students are there. Due to their poverty, sometimes they drop out from the school. She is also not exemption. She is a dropout children due to her poverty. At the age of 16, she was dropout from the school. But she is interested to continue in the studies. She landed a job that required her work from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. So she did some job from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. But here, what happened here, she felt monotonous. Monotonous means here boring. Monotonous means here boring. She felt the job boring. Why means here no scope for learning anything. She wants to learn more and more. But here in that task, what will happen? No scope for learning anything. That's why she wanted to write a resignation letter to boss. She wrote a letter and submitted to her boss. The boss, what happened, he didn't send her from that company. What will happen? He was impressed. She also convinced him why she wrote a letter to her boss. Finally, he didn't give permission to leave from that company. He helped her to promote in that lens technology. Due to that, was a turning point for our Zhou Quinfei. Fourth paragraph. When she had saved enough money, she took the help of her relatives and set up a workshop for making watch lenses. Much of what she knew about making lenses was self-taught. She now began to try out different ways of improving the quality of the lenses that she stole. She began to acquire a reputation for making the finest watch lenses available in the market. Along the way, she married and had a child. She then divorced, married again and had another child. The meaning of this paragraph is that when she earned money, this is in past perfect tense here, add plus V3. When she had saved some money, she took the help of her relatives and also set up one company like Stens Technology, one industry like the Lens Technology. That she helped village people, and also village people, the relatives also helped for her to become successful rich woman. So here, much of what she know about making lens was self-taught. She didn't go for any coaching. She learnt lens technology her own. She didn't go for anywhere. She's there. Day and night she worked hard, and also for improvement of the quality of the glass, she worked hard. And also she got the name national wide and international wide. Along the way she married and had a child. See here. Due to her foreign background, she married and also had a child. Next, she divorced, is quite common in foreign countries, and also married again and had another child. So here first two marriages happened in her life. First married and one baby, and also next she married and also one more baby. But due to the, even though some clashes in family, whatever it is, but it is not affected in personal growth. Next, the advent of the mobile phone made Ms. Zhou a billionaire. In 2003, she was still making watch lenses when she received a call from the mobile giant Motorola. They wanted her to make screens for mobile phones. Until then, mobile screens were made of plastic. But glass would be more resistant to scratches and provide sharper images for text and multimedia. Joe got hand board and created the screens of Motorola's Razr V3. The meaning of this paragraph means here, the coming of mobiles made her a billionaire. These days, you know, coming of Corona and COVID-19, novel Corona situation made sanitizer companies and mask companies become rich. Here, the advent means coming. The coming of mobile phones, what will happen? Joe became billionaire. In 2003, she was still making watch lenses. She was making, what was the trend? Means only making watch lenses only. When she was making watch lenses, so she got offer from Motorola, first smartphone. So here, they wanted her to make screens for mobile phones. Until then, mobile screens were made of plastic. Before, what happened means here, mobile phones are mostly, the glasses are only plastic only for touch screens. Later, after plastic, what will happen? Demand for glasses. But glass would be more resistant to scratches and provide sharper images for text and multimedia. So this glass is best for giving clarity in mobile, whatever it is. Joe got on board and created the screens of Motorola. So here another one, what does a lens technology produce? These are the questions. What does lens technology produce and who are the biggest customers means here? Mobile users are the, what does the lens technology produce means? So lens technology will produce lenses. And also who are its biggest customers means here? Mobile users are the biggest customers. Why do you think Motorola approached lens technology and not any other lens maker means here? She is best in making lens technologies. Later, soon HTC, Nokia and Samsung placed order with her. Then in 2007, Apple entered the market with iPhone, which has a keyboard enabled touch screen. Apple figured Joe's lens technology as its supplier. Consequently, Ms. Joe invested heavily in new facilities and skilled technicians. Within 5 years, she set up manufacturing plants in 3 cities. See, orders also came from HTC, Nokia and Samsung. So, this is a good example for students to get motivated. Thank you so much.